So it's that time of year, if you have kids going back to college, you're starting to buy dorm supplies and find sheets for their beds. But don't forget, Uncle Sam offers a bunch of tax breaks. Lisa Greene-Lewis, TurboTax expert and CPA, is with us now to talk through them. So Lisa, first let's start with the new legislation. What do we need to know?
The first thing you need to know is that the freeze on paying your federal student loans is off. And starting September, you're going to start seeing interest in your account, and then you have to start making payments in October. So that's a key thing to remember, because that pause was on for a couple of years due to COVID. And then another key piece of legislation that came up on June 30th is the Supreme Court, they did block the student loan relief that was up to $10,000 for federal student loans and $20,000 for Pell Grants. So that is blocked right now.
So just as a reminder too, kids don't have to start paying these loans back until they finish with school, right? So there's no need to panic just yet.
Yeah, it depends on your loan, but in some cases, yes, they do allow a certain amount of time after you finish school. I think it's up to 6 months after you finish school, because I guess they want to give your kids time to find a job and everything.
Right, because otherwise parents have to pay the bill. So yeah, God bless Uncle Sam on that one. But so check your loan. That's super important. Let's now talk about these education credits that people often forget. American Opportunity is the first one. I think people leave these on the table a lot.
Yeah, they do. A lot of people are unaware of them. And the American Opportunity tax credit, that's for up to your first 4 years of college, and it's up to $2,500. And then the lifetime learning credit, that can be, it doesn't have to be your first 4 years of college. It's actually after your 4 years, and it can be for one class. So that is one thing to remember for students as well as parents.
And the final thing we should talk about is who takes these credits? Is it the kids? Is it the parents? I guess it depends.
Yes, I always recommend, you know, having a conversation about who would be eligible, because these are income-based credits. And so a lot of times parents don't even qualify, but they're claiming their child as a dependent. So their child can't claim these credits. But if you're not getting any benefit from claiming your child because of your income, then you should have your child, you know, file their taxes, especially, you know, a lot of college students, they work side jobs, but they think they don't make enough money to file because they're not at the IRS income threshold. But, you know, they're leaving money on the table, especially if they had federal taxes taken out and they're eligible for these education tax credits.
Yeah, that's certainly a conversation I'm going to be having with my son who just graduated this year. Lisa Greene-Lewis, TurboTax expert and CPA, thank you so much for all of that.
Thank you for having me.